the national anthem. I invite our Vice Chancellor to declare the convocation open.
Mr. President, sir, may I have your permission to declare the convocation open? I declare the convocation open. Namaskar, everybody. Vanakkam. Distinguished Chief Guest, Hon'ble Shri Ram Nath Kovind, President of India and Visitor of Pondicherry University, Hon'ble Lieutenant Governor of Union Territory of Pondicherry, and the Chief Rector of Pondicherry University, Dr. Kiran Bedi, IPS retired, Honorable Chief Minister of Puducherry, Shri V. Narayana Swami, respected Minister of Electricity, Education and Agriculture, Shri R. Kamalakaran, respected Minister of Revenue, Industries and Commerce, Transport, Information Technology, Forests, Workforce, Minority Affairs, Shri M.O.H.F. Shahjahan, sir, respected Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Shri Vaidya Lingam, respected Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, Shri N. Gopalakrishnan, the members of various university bodies, distinguished members of faculty, staff, all other officers from Puducherry government, graduating students, their respected parents, donors of various medals and prizes, honored guests, media persons, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Executive Council and other statutory bodies of Pondicherry University and on my own behalf, it gives me an immense pleasure in extending a very warm and cordial welcome to all of you to this 27th annual convocation of the University. I welcome my esteemed Chief Guest, Hon'ble Shri Ram Nath Kovind, President of India. Shri Ram Nath Kovind took the oath as the 14th President of India on 25th July 2017. A lawyer, a veteran parliamentarian, and an ardent, long-time champion of equality in society and integrity in Indian public life, Shri Ram Nath Kovind was counsel of Union Government of India in Delhi High Court from 1977 to 1979. He became an advocate on record of the Supreme Court of India in 1978. Thereafter, from 1980 to 1993, he was the Union Government Standing Counsel in Supreme Court. He practiced at Delhi High Court with absolute distinction and Supreme Court for 16 years till 1993. Shri Ram Nath Kovind then was elected as a member of Rajya Sabha, that is our upper house of parliament, from Uttar Pradesh in April 1994. He served for two consecutive terms of 6 years each till March 2006. A keen parliamentarian, Shri Kovind served on the Parliament Committee on Welfare of Scheduled Castes and Tribes, Parliamentary Committee on Home Affairs, Parliamentary Committee on Petroleum and Natural Gas, and many other committees. Shri Kovind was also elected as member of the Board of Management of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University, Lucknow, which is a central university, as you all know, and as a member of the Board of Governors of Indian Institute of Management, Kolkata. As a member of Indian delegation, he addressed the United Nations General Assembly on 22nd October 2003, which was a great honor for our country. During his long career, Shri Kovind has traveled widely across the globe to many countries. As President of India, Shri Ram Nath Kovind has visited many countries, which include Djibouti, Ethiopia, Mauritius, Madagascar, Kingdom of Swaziland, Zambia, Greece, and many other countries. Sir, it is a good fortune that you have kindly accepted our invitation and consented to be with us today on the 27th annual convocation and deliver the convocation address. We feel extremely honored and blessed to welcome you here, sir, amidst us. Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Pondicherry, Dr. Kiran Bedi, IPS, retired, and Chief Rector of the University, I have been calling her on many an occasion as a Karma Yogi. She is a true Karma Yogi who strictly follows the dictum of service before self. In 2003, Mrs. Bedi became the first woman and the first Indian to be appointed as United Nations Civilian Police Advisor. Dr. Kiran Bedi did not start her career as a cop, but as a lecturer in political science at the Khalsa College for Women in Amritsar way back in 1970. After 2 years of her teaching career, she cleared the civil services examination and became an IPS officer. This made her the first woman in India to join these services. She also founded two voluntary non-governmental organizations, Navjyoti in 1988 and Indian Vision Foundation in 1994, both of which were established to operate the adult literacy and the women empowerment. She is also an accomplished tennis player and won several championships in Asia. As a dynamic administrative head of Pondicherry, she has won the admiration and respect of Pondicherrians. I wholeheartedly welcome her to our university, and she is a great pillar of strength for our university. She has also inaugurated several of our projects and initiatives as the chief rector of our university. Whenever we need her, she never says no to anything. That's the best part of her nature and style of working. I wholeheartedly welcome our esteemed Chief Minister, Shri V. Narayana Swami. Ever since he has taken over as the Chief Minister of Pondicherry, he has always been willing to support us in whatever way possible. Hailing from a humble background, he was the first graduate in his family. After his bachelor's degree in Tagore Arts College, he started law in Annamalai University. He studied law in Annamalai University, Chidambaram, and even practiced as a lawyer for some time before he entered politics. He was elected to the Rajya Sabha for 3 times during 1985 to 1997 and was elected to 15th Lok Sabha during 2009. He also served as Minister for State for Planning, Parliamentary Affairs and Prime Minister's Office. As a member of various bodies, he has visited several countries. It is again my privilege to welcome our esteemed guest, respected Minister of Electricity, Education and Agriculture, Shri Kamala Kannan, respected Minister for Revenue, Industries and Commerce, Transport, Information Technology, Forest, Transport, Shri MOHF Shah Jahan, respected Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Shri Vaidyalingam, respected Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, Shri N. Gokul Krishnan. In fact, their active involvement in developing and improving quality of education in Pondicherry is indeed very praiseworthy. And whenever we require any assistance from them, they are all there at a call. Pondicherry, as you all know, is a very vibrant city, very positive city, full of spirituality, and a place where the pollution is at zero level, which goes to the credit of all Pondicherrians. University started in 1985 and has campuses in 4 different states. It is making very rapid strides of late. The term education in university stands for universalization of education. And keeping that in mind, Pondicherry University has all the subjects, all courses, and almost all degrees which should be there are being looked after here in campus. University is making very wonderful progress in the area of research. Almost all research faculty members here have good projects, and of late we had applied for research projects worth 190 crores, out of which many have been sanctioned. Our university is the only one which has been sanctioned 7 SPARC projects, which is a kind of project which involves great amount of international understanding. The university is making wonderful progress in all areas that a university is supposed to be doing. And of late, In the last 2 years, we have entered into memorandum of understandings with many universities across the globe, and that is giving a chance for our students and faculty to visit those countries, and they in exchange come over to our country for various academic interactions. At the initiative of our respected visitor, he advised all the universities to move from CSR to USR, that is from corporate social responsibility to university social responsibility. This was an initiative which was started by our visitor, who is very keen that all the universities in India should make wonderful progress in all fronts. And this is one of the best initiatives taken in that direction. So therefore, keeping that in mind, our university adopted this scheme, this scheme which was initiated by our respected visitor, and we took this in a big way. Under this, our university adopted 103 villages, and our workers are going there once in a month. They guide them in terms of maintaining the cleanliness, health services, education, and solid waste management. This will help all the villagers in becoming a model village and will improve the life of all villagers in and around Pondicherry. It is a matter of joy that 189 young achievers are getting gold medals for their distinguished performance. I congratulate all of them for their remarkable achievement. I also congratulate all degree holders once again, and I am really proud of their achievements. They are really bringing a good name to our university. Being trained in one of the best universities in India, you are the luckiest of the students, and there is much more to do in life ahead for all of you. Today marks a new beginning for all of you to embark on a journey which will enable you to achieve many more laurels in future. Towards the end, I request each of you to serve with confidence for the betterment of our country. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, sir.
Honorable President of India, Shri Ram Nath Kovind, visitor to Pondicherry University. Honorable First Lady, Srimati Ram Nath Kovind. Our Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Pondicherry, Dr. Kiran Bedi, ma'am. Our Honorable Chief Minister of Pondicherry, Shri Narayana Swamiji. We have lots of women's hostels, all named after rivers of India. Today we inaugurate the new hostel building, Narmada Hostel for Women. I request our chief guest to inaugurate the Narmada Hostel.
Sir, Vice Chancellor, I, Professor S. Balakrishnan, Director, Directorate of Studies, Educational Innovation and Rural Reconstruction, present unto you these candidates who have been certified after examination to be duly qualified to receive the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Arts, Master of Science, Master of Business Administration, Master of Commerce, Master of Law, Master of Technology, Doctor of Medicine, Master of Surgery, Master of Dental Surgery, Master of Veterinary Sciences, PG Diploma in Medical Entomology, Master of Education, Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Vocational Technologies, Bachelor of Commerce, Bachelor of Law, Bachelor of Technology, Bachelor of Medicine and Surgery, Bachelor of Ayurvedic Medicine and Surgery, Bachelor of Dental Surgery, Bachelor of Veterinary Sciences, and Bachelor of Education. The candidates as listed in the respective schools in person and in absentia, and the students of Directorate of Distance Education in absentia, the degrees of Pondicherry University.
For saving time, I'll only read the promise on behalf of all the candidates. We, the candidates admitted to various degrees, promise and declare over oath that we shall in thought, word and deed ever endeavor to be scrupulously honest in the discharge of our duties, in our profession and shall uphold the dignity and integrity of our profession and the honor of our university. We shall uphold and advance social order and the well-being of our fellow members and shall devote all our energy to promote unity, integrity and the secular ideals of the country. Thank you.
We now move to the joyous occasion when the President will distribute the gold medals to a few of our graduates.
Sir, Vice Chancellor, I, Professor D. Lazar, Controller of Examination in Charge, present unto you these candidates who are to be awarded gold medals for securing first positions in various university examinations, and they shall appear before you to receive the gold medals in person. Former President of India, Shri K.R. Narayanan Gold Medal for the best SC/ST student among PG courses, MBA Insurance Management, Aruna J. Provalar Govindaswamy Pattammal Gold Medal, Srimadi Mangalam Bauda Gold Medal, Mahindra Vada VC Memorial Gold Medal, Shri Amanullah Sahib Memorial Gold Medal for MBA, Shubhasini N. Tamil Nadu Mercantile Bank Gold Medal for MBA Banking Technology, Sweta S. Bank of Maharashtra Gold Medal for MCOM Accounting and Taxation, Renu Meera Matthew. National Academy of Science India Gold Medal for MSc Mathematics 5-year integrated courses, Punita K. Dharam Raj Bali Memorial Gold Medal for MSc Bioinformatics, Aishwarya Swine. Mudaliyandan Vainava Ilakkiyam Gold Medal for MA Sanskrit, Saundarya S. Joseph Josephine Sandasamy Gold Medal for MA Sociology, Varsha K. Thomas. Pondicherry University Gold Medal
for M.Tech Computer Science and Engineering, Kanimoli J. Pondicherry University Gold Medal for MD Radio Diagnosis, Pidugulla Rakesh. Thank you, sir.
India and visitor of Pondicherry University will now deliver the convocation address.
Lieutenant Governor of Union Territory of Puducherry, Dr. Kiran Bedi, Chief Minister of Puducherry, Sri N. Narayan Sami, Vice Chancellor, Professor Gurmeet Singh, students, faculty, and other staff members, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to participate in the 27th Convocation of Pondicherry University. As we all know, Puducherry is the land of poets, patriots, and pious souls. It has a blend of spirituality and a uniquely rich heritage, a confluence of the best of French and Tamil cultures. There is a strong French influence on this beautiful town, which is visible in its buildings and streets as a result of the centuries-old relations it has maintained with France. Puducherry is also known around the world thanks to Maharshi Aurobindo and the mother. The great poet, freedom fighter and a spiritual leader chose this peaceful place to make his abode and remained here till his death. The Aurobindo Ashram and Aurovil continue to attract from around the globe people who are in search of peace and inner happiness. Puducherry is also where Tamil revolutionary poets like Bhartiyar and Bharti Dasan wrote their immortal verses. There is another occasion for happiness. I had the privilege to award gold medals to only 10 students. And as we all have noticed, out of 10, there were 9 girls. Now, another wonderful thing which I noticed, I was informed that the total awardees of gold medalist are 189. And out of 189 girls, the number of girls goes to 137 and boys only 52. It reflects the future of our country. It also reflects the leadership quality amongst our daughters. And my best wishes to all of them. Ladies and gentlemen, when I visit this land, my memory goes back to the journey I had undertaken to this beautiful place as Member of Parliament. My friend and fellow member in the Parliament and an eminent leader, M.O.H. Farooq, then invited me to his home for tea. We had a lively interaction. Since then, my affection for Pondicherry continues to grow with the passage of time. Pondicherry University was established as a central university way back in 1985 by an Act of Parliament to provide instructional and research facilities to encourage interdisciplinary studies. This student-friendly institution of higher learning has been emerging as a world-class university with a praiseworthy increase in students' intake as well as in various rankings and overall performance. It is heartening to learn that here there are about 6,500 enrolled students for the academic year of 2019 and 20. And close to half of them are female students. A majority of students are from other states, and the student-teacher ratio is a healthy one, that is 16.7 to 1. Ladies and gentlemen, whether it is a university or any other entity, finally, we all are part of the society, and we all have our responsibility towards the society. The government has encouraged corporate firms to spend a part of their profits for society via corporate social responsibility. I appreciate this concept and I believe it should be expanded. I have often spoken about the need to extend the concept of our universities. I call it from corporate social responsibility to university social responsibility. Since I am passionate about it, I am especially happy to learn that the Lieutenant Governor of Pondicherry and Chief Rector of Pondicherry University, Dr. Kiran Bedi, launched that project here in July last year. I also commend the contribution of my good friend and a colleague from my Rajya Sabha days, Chief Minister Shri V. Narayan Sami, in creating a conducive environment for growth of education in the whole state. I am glad that the social responsibility projects of the university have already registered remarkable achievements, including the inauguration of community services such as blood donation, organ donation, eye checkup, photo exhibition, and health checkup in Pondicherry University Community College. Another heartening development that has pleased me is on the cleanliness front. Pondicherry University is on the way to become the first university to implement Swachh Bharat in the campus. It has prepared a detailed project report and submitted it to the Ministry of Urban Development, the Government of India. Moreover, the university and its affiliated colleges in and around the campus have adopted 103 villages. Efforts are on to develop them as model villages. The university's move to open a community college to help rural youth is commendable. The motto of Pondicherry University Community College is education for employment through skills formation. Educational activities are designed in line with the needs and demands of the local community. More specifically, the main objective of this college is to offer job-oriented courses based on the community demand for specific manpower. In short, community college is for the community and of the community. The university has indeed set its bar high, and its ambition is to provide that quality of education which can match the best in the world. For this purpose, it has joined hands with several prestigious institutions from Taiwan, Korea, France, and Switzerland. Another issue that is close to my heart is setting up of an endowment fund with the help of its alumni. A generous donation by ex-students would create a high level of motivation for the university to aspire for the best. I am sure the students have made the best use of the great opportunities offered by the university. As many as 335 PhD scholars, 26 MPhil researchers, and a large number of postgraduate, undergraduate, and distance education students are obtaining their degrees in this convocation. Also, 189 bright minds are going to be honored with gold medals. This is a memorable day for you, and it is a matter of pride for your parents too. Let me congratulate you again on receiving the degrees you rightly deserve. Some of you will now pursue further studies and some will bid goodbye to the campus life and begin a new life. To all of you, I wish all the best. In its competitive rush, the world can often be less kind, less generous. But it will surely find balance if you try to be more kind and more generous. In no small measure, this day also belongs to the faculty. You have not only taught these wonderful students, you have also brought laurels for the university by winning prestigious national and international awards and prizes and publishing your research outcomes in journals of high repute. Scholarly pursuits are always joint endeavors, and for supporting the students and teachers, the administration and the non-teaching staff too must be complimented. In conclusion, I turn to the university's anthem with its words so uplifting and inspiring. It pays homage to Bharti, Bharti Dasan and Arvindo. It begins with the famous ancient mantra from Brihadaranyak Upanishad, which says, Tamso Ma Jyotirgamay, from darkness unto light, lead us. In the spirit of the anthem, I extend my best wishes to the whole university community and wish that the university grow ever more and may you prosper forever. Thank you all. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. We are blessed indeed to receive your blessings today. Our Vice Chancellor will now declare this part of the convocation closed.
I dissolve this convocation. Thank you.
Kindly rise for the national anthem. Kindly remain standing in your respective positions until the academic procession leaves the auditorium. Thank you.